Welcome to the ThinkCell tutorials. This video shows you how to build stacked column and bar charts, clustered charts, and 100% charts with ThinkCell. Stacked charts are probably the most commonly used chart type of all. To insert one into your presentation, go to the ThinkCell tab in the PowerPoint ribbon, open the Elements menu, and look for the Stacked icon. Move your mouse over the four little arrows around the icon. The arrow pointing up is for inserting a vertical column chart. The arrow pointing right for inserting a horizontal bar chart. The arrows pointing down and left will insert flipped versions of the two. Let's say you want to create a stacked bar chart. Click on the arrow to the right of the stacked icon. The orange insertion frame appears on the slide. Click once to place your chart on the slide. With ThinkCell, you can also change the orientation of the stacked chart after insertion. For instance, to turn a bar into a column chart. Just select the chart with your mouse, click on and hold the rotation handle, and drag to the position where the ends of the stacks should point to. Release to set the new orientation of your chart. Open the datasheet by double-clicking on the chart and enter your data. ThinkCell organizes the stacked segments according to the visual order of the datasheet. The chart is automatically updated while you type in your values and text. Add or remove as many series and categories as you need in the datasheet. The colors of the different series depend on the settings in your slide master. You can, of course, change them manually if needed via the color controls in the floating toolbar. For details on this, please watch our basic concepts tutorial. By default, a newly inserted stacked chart comes with category, series, segment, and total labels. If you would like to change which label types are displayed, right-click onto the chart and choose the label options from the context menu. For more details on working with ThinkCell's text labels, please watch our tutorial video, Text Labels. You may also adjust the width of the columns or bars in your chart. Click on a segment and drag one of the handles that appear. While dragging, a tooltip shows the resulting gap. The gap width is displayed as a percentage of the column width. A value of 50%, for instance, means that each gap is half as wide as a column. Release the mouse button when you are satisfied with the column width. Suppose you have a stacked chart like this that has a number of small segments in a category. Therefore, you would like to combine them into one segment for Other to make the chart more accessible at a glance. With ThinkCell, you can do this in just a few clicks. Just select all segments that you would like to combine in the Other series. For example, by shift-clicking on them, then right-click into the selection and choose Move to Other Series from the context menu. The selected segments are combined into one for each category, given a new fill color, and the corresponding series label is changed to Other. Once you have added an Other series, you can also include additional segments in it or exclude segments that should be displayed individually again by selecting one of the segments from Other and dragging the handle that appears up or down. Let's turn to the clustered chart. A clustered chart is very similar to a stacked column or bar chart, but clusters several column or bar segments of a category beside each other instead of on top of each other. To create a clustered chart, open the Elements menu, click on the Clustered icon, and position your chart on the slide. As with the stacked chart, you can insert the clustered chart in four different orientations with the help of the small arrows, or rotate it after insertion. In the datasheet, each cluster has its data column, where the topmost cell corresponds to the chart column furthest to the left of this cluster. When you enter another row of data, A column is added to the cluster in the chart. The default cluster chart comes with category and total labels. If you name the series in the datasheet, the chart will also display a legend. If needed, you can easily move the legend by clicking on its frame and dragging it to a different position. To remove the legend, select it and hit the Delete key. If you would like to build a stacked cluster chart, you start with a stack chart and modify it as follows. Enter your data into the datasheet, including category names for the different clusters. Click on any segment of the chart. Drag the column width handle until the tooltip shows 0% gap and release. All columns move together without any gaps between them. If the segments of your chart do not have an outline, multi-select all segments and pick an outline style and color from the floating toolbar. Now move your mouse to the baseline at the point where your first cluster ends and click on the orange rectangle that appears. Hold down the mouse button and drag the gray double arrow to the right. Release when you see the tooltip for one category gap. A gap between your first cluster and the second is inserted. Repeat this for other gaps between clusters. Adjust the size of the chart if needed. Finally, let's have a look at the 100% chart. It is a variation of a stacked chart with all columns typically adding up to the same height, 100%. It can be used to compare different categories with each other. For example, the sales of certain products within particular geographical regions. Open the Elements menu and look for the 100% chart icon. Decide which orientation your chart should have and click on the corresponding arrow. Click again to place the chart on the slide. The default datasheet of the 100% chart has the values formatted as percentages and shows totals in the 100% row. If this is the format you would like to work with, just type in your percentage values and totals for each category if needed. Name your series and categories to complete your 100% chart. Now you are done. You can also use absolute values in the datasheet of your 100% chart and have ThinkCell calculate the percentages in the chart. To do this, select all cells with your mouse and click Add/Remove% formatting of cells in the toolbar of the datasheet. The format of the cells changes to absolute values. Delete the entries in the 100% row. Now you can enter the absolute values for your different series into the datasheet. ThinkCell automatically calculates the percentage values and the totals of each category in the chart. For more information on how to work with absolute values and percentages in the datasheet, please watch our tutorial video on data entry. With ThinkCell, you can also create 100% charts with columns that do not necessarily add up to 100%. If a column totals to more or less than 100%, it is rendered accordingly. The three chart types that we featured in this video, stacked chart, clustered chart, and 100% chart, all share a common structure in regard to their datasheet. ThinkCell allows to switch between these chart types even after you've entered your data. Let's see how this is done. Left-click on a free spot within the chart area to open the floating toolbar. Click on the chart type control box. The drop-down menu opens, and you can see the different chart types that you can switch to. Apart from the three chart types that we looked at in this video, you can also pick Area, Area 100%, and Line Chart. There is a separate tutorial video for these chart types. For now, let's say you want to turn your stacked column chart into a clustered column chart. All you have to do is click on Clustered from the chart type control. Your data is now interpreted and displayed as a clustered chart. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkSell tutorials.